we're all chasing inspiration. And whether we decide to let it be or make something of it is up to us. This year I traveled the world for one reason. And instead of just telling you what happened, well, I thought I'd show you. I'm Jacob, and I'm the one that creates the videos you see on this YouTube channel. Thank you for all the kind words and support on my video so far. It's been truly overwhelming, and you guys are amazing, so thank you. I know it's been a while since I've last uploaded, over a year now, and this is because I was still in school at the time, and making more travel videos just wasn't possible. My initial plan was to finish the school year and make videos the following summer, but little things started to eat away at me, like all the support from you guys asking when the next video will be. But the biggest thing was I just couldn't concentrate in class because all I would do was think about making videos. Up until that point, I felt like I hadn't made a video that I was completely satisfied with from start to finish. I wanted to change my life and work towards doing the thing that I loved most for a living. At school, I felt like I was stuck, and I remember thinking I would do anything to be out in the world right now working towards that goal instead of waiting for another year to pass and missing my opportunity. By a stroke of luck, I guess, one of my best friends now was planning a trip to the Arctic Circle and extended an invite to me. Now, those of you that are in university or college know that missing a month of school would seriously hurt your grades and jeopardize your ability to finish your degree. So I told my friend, listen, if I were to put my studies on hold, I'd have to make the best of it, travel the entire semester, and have my shot at all of this. Now, this was a huge shot in the dark for me. I wasn't sure how my parents were going to react to the idea. It was pretty ambitious, and the longest I'd been away from home prior to this was like a couple weeks tops. Not to mention, I'd have to exhaust pretty much all of my savings working retail and minimum wage jobs the last couple of years. But there was this voice in me saying, like, if you don't do this, you may never. And so I thought about it long and hard and did what any rational thinking 20-year-old would do. I bought the next ticket. My plan was simple. There were a bunch of countries on my list that I wanted to hit. Mostly ones I hadn't been to before and others I had been to, like Indonesia. It was a pretty daunting task, but doing something like this had been a dream of mine for the past few years, and I knew it would be more fun than anything. Finally, it was time to depart. First stop, the Arctic Circle. After spending some time in the Arctic, I had a few weeks to kill, so I visited some places in Europe I hadn't been to before. I went to London, skated and surfed in Portugal, visited the Eiffel Tower, and explored the coastal cliffs in Etretat. And after my time in Europe was up, I returned to Bali. From Bali, my friends and I flew to the Philippines, and I gotta say, it's one of the most beautiful places I've ever visited. After the Philippines, I initially had plans to visit Turkey, Dubai, and a couple of other countries before heading home. But when I got the opportunity to travel through Mongolia with world-famous German photographer Max Munch, I just couldn't pass it up. Max runs his own tour company in Mongolia called Follow the Tracks, and it's this self-drive experience across the entire country, ranging from the mountains all the way to the desert. It's absolutely incredible. I went to Mongolia with Max, and let me tell you, it's one of the most unique and otherworldly places I've ever been.
Deep in the ocean, dead and cast away. Her innocence is burning in flames. A million miles from home, I'm walking ahead. I'm frozen to the bones. I am a soldier on my own. I don't know the way. I'm riding up the heights of shame. I'm waiting for the call, the hand on the chest. I'm ready for the fight and fate.
We spent the next 3 weeks exploring the entire country, and I experienced some of the craziest weather I have ever been in. We kept on trekking and spent time with a nomad family. Lastly, we headed to the mountains. The whole experience was so memorable, like seeing camels for the first time and camping out every night underneath the stars. But without a doubt, the most incredible moment of the trip was meeting an eagle hunter. Mongolia was wild. It's unlike any other place I've ever been, and I hope to be back there sometime in the future. After Mongolia, I headed back to Canada and spent some time with friends and family. After about a month, I visited a bunch of summer camps for a few weeks and filmed it all. That was a ton of fun. And once that was done, went straight to Norway to road trip throughout Lofoten and Senja with my friends. I've finished editing that video from that trip, and I'm stoked to share it with you guys in about a week. So I don't want to leak too much of that footage right now, but it's coming soon, so stay tuned. After Norway, I visited Greece for the first time with my family. I am Greek for those who don't know, so being able to spend time with family, visiting relatives, eating Greek food, and exploring the islands was just amazing. And after Greece, I came home with plans of making that video I wanted to create for this YouTube channel. And did I make the video? No. I got cold feet. Looking back through all my footage, I realized that I was in the same situation that I started in. And that hit me hard. I didn't want to create anything at that point, and I don't want to say I failed, but me being naturally hard on myself, I did feel a sense of failure. And I wasn't sure how to bounce back and where to go from there. When out of the blue, my friend Kevin hit me up. And in hindsight, this really was perfect timing. Kevin invited me to Africa to help tell the story of the Rateti Elephant Sanctuary and what they're doing to rescue and recover orphaned elephants from the likes of drought, poaching, etc. And so I'm sure you've caught on to the trend by now. Obviously, I went. Yeah, that was my year, and looking back, I didn't get to create that video I wanted to, but that's okay.
You forgot about the Northern Lights.
You serious? You're kidding. Dude, roll the tape. After a couple of weeks in the Arctic Circle with no luck seeing any Northern Lights, it all came down to our last couple of nights in Senja, Norway.
Hopefully we see some Northern Lights tonight.
Finally, the night sky cleared, and what happened next, well, I'll just show you. This year was amazing, and I wouldn't have wished for it to have gone any other way. Thanks to everyone for sticking around all this time, and I'll catch you in the next video.